نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولقد أرسلنا نوحا وإبراهيم وجعلنا في ذريتهما النبوة والكتاب فمنهم مهتد وكثير منهم فاسقون إلى آخر السورة صدق الله العظيم. We have read 25 آيات of Surah Al-Hadid. First 6 آيات refer to the person and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the highest academic level. Then 2 demands, آمنوا أنفقوا. Then why do you not have faith? A rebuke. If you feel actually you don't have the real faith, turn to Quran. Second rebuke, why don't you spend for the cause of Allah? And in that, if the conditions are bad, there is no hope for the establishment of the deen of Allah, still you spend for the deen of Allah, your energies, your life, your time, and your belongings, you will have greater regard than those who will be doing it after the attainment of victory. Then what is the objective of it? And that is to establish the system of justice on earth given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for that, a stage might come when you have to go to the battlefield. But that is the last stage. For that, first of all, there should be some propagation of the ideology. Then whosoever accept it, organize them, train them. And when this process reaches a certain level, then only you can challenge the system. But the final point has been mentioned. لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانَ لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ. The same thing as we read in Surah Ash-Shura. وَأُمِرْتُ لِأَعْدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ. I have been sent to establish justice among you. I am not a soothsayer or a sermon sayer or a poet or a storyteller, nothing of the sort. I have been sent to establish justice. So this is the essence. Now there else is a mistake also. When you are told that this life is nothing, real life is of akhira, of the hereafter, then sometimes there is a tendency for what we call ascetism, rahbaniyat, see this world. Why marrying? Why having family life? Why bothering for all these things? Go to some caves or somewhere else, solitary places. Just remember your Lord. Have tried to have a communion with Him. But this is wrong. Islam says you don't love this world. But you have to change this world. Live here. Change it. You have to be an activist, not a passive rahib. An ascetic, passive ascetic, sitting aside from the world. He doesn't care whether there are injustices being done over here. Oppressions are being done over here. No, he doesn't care. He is there. In his monastery or something else, sitting over there. No, no, no. This is not Islam. So this actually was a mistake committed by the followers of one of the Ulul Azm min al-Rusul, and that was Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. People who came to believe in him, they twisted their religion towards rahbaniyat, ascetism. So this mistake is pointed out here in the remaining 4 ayat of the surah. And for that purpose, Allah starts with Nuh. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا وَإِبْرَاهِيمًا. And verily we sent Nuh and Ibrahim. وَجَعَلْنَا فِي ذُرِّيَّتِهِمَا النُّبُوَّةَ وَالْكِتَابَ. And we placed our prophethood and the book in the progeny of Nuh and Ibrahim. فَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِدٌ. Out of the progeny of the two, there are who are tightly guided. وَكَثِيرٌ مِنْهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. But most of them are transgressors. Now, ثُمَّ قَفَّيْنَا عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ بِرُسُولِنَا. Then we meet our messengers to follow in their footsteps. وقفينا بعيسى ابن مريم and we made عيسى son of مريم to follow وجعلنا في قلوب الذين اتبعوه رافة ورحمة وآتيناه الإنجيل and we gave عيسى إنجيل the gospel and we placed in the hearts of those who followed him tenderness and mercy and compassion. This was a special condition, you know, of the Hawariyin of Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wasalam. وَرَهْبَانِيَّةَ لِبْتَدَعُوهَا But monasticism and asceticism was something which they invented. مَا كَتَبْنَاهَا عَلَيْهِمْ We have not made it compulsory on them. This was their decision. This was the wrong turn they took. إِلَّا اتِّغَارِ رِضْوَانِ اللَّهِ We had only made it compulsory for them to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then, when they adopted asceticism, فَمَا رَعَوْهَا حَقَّ رِعَيَتِهَا Then, they could not observe it with the due observance. فَآتَنَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ So we gave to those among them who had real faith and belief and who came to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that can also be mentioned over here. To them we gave their reward, وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ But most of them are also transgressors. So this is to point out this wrong term. Don't love this world, but live in it. Try to fashion it on the right path. Take it to the justice, system of justice, and establish the deen of Allah over here. This is the test of your faith and your iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وآمنوا برسوله يؤتكم كفلين من رحمته Oh you who profess to believe in Allah have fear of Allah and believe in His messenger what does it mean the real conviction that the model for us is the person of Muhammad we have to follow him he was not an ascetic He didn't start a monastic type of system, no. He fought for the cause of Allah. He was an activist. He challenged falsehood. He took his men to the battlefield, led them to the battlefield. So you have to follow him. See how during the Makki period he propagated his ideas. Then those who accepted Iman, organized them, trained them with the permanent order and no retaliation. Whatever persecution comes to you, verbal or physical, you have to take it patiently without any retaliation. But then, when he thought he has now enough strength with him, he challenged the falsehood, the system, the ascendancy of Quraysh. He fought them. And then he established the deen of Allah in the Arabian Peninsula. So this is the model. Don't follow any other model. You have not to follow the model of Jesus. No. Model for you is Muhammad. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ Jesus had his own methodology. But you have to follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are the Ummah of Muhammad. So here you know, اتقوا الله وآمنوا برسوله Emphasis on Iman, on the Messenger. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وآمنوا برسوله يؤتكم كفلين من رحمته Allah will give you twofold from His mercy ويجعل لكم نورا تمشون به and then He will give you the light with which you will be able to walk. To walk in this world also, you need a light, guidance. And to cross that bridge of As-Sirat on the Day of Judgment, you'll be needing a light. Allah will give you. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ Whatever shortcomings, Allah will forgive them. وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ Verily, Allah is forgiving, merciful. لِأَلَّا يَعْلَمَ أَهْلُ الْكِتَابِ أَلَّا يَقْدِرُونَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ So that the people of the book should not think that they have now no access over the bounty of Allah. They have the access. They can even now believe in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Come. Aminu bi rasulihi. You believe in Musa, you believe in Ibrahim, and so on and so forth. Seven believe in Muhammad also. So all the fuzzle, you know, the gates of fuzzle, you know, they will be opened. As we read in Surah Bani Israel, أَصَى رَبَّكُمَ يَرْحَمَكُمْ وَإِنْ عُدْتُمْ عُدْنَا. Your Lord is ready to have mercy upon you even now. Go you under the shelter of the messengerhood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The gates are open. لِأَلَّا يَكُونَ أَهْلُ الْكِتَابِ أَلَّا يَقْدِرُونَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَأَنَّ الْفَضْلَ بِيَدِ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. The bounty is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's His prerogative. To whom He wants, He grants it. وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ. And definitely Allah is of infinite bounty. Now we come to Surah Al-Mujadala. The first four ayat of Surah Al-Mujadala, they discuss a particular issue of family laws. But the rest of the 18 ayat, they give us a picture of two parties. Party of Satan, party of Allah. As we have seen, when you know this dawah, this call to Allah, and the call to establish the system of justice given by Allah, when this dawah is given, there is bound to be a resistance. Then there will be a polarization in this society. Some people who come, accept the call, they are ready to devote their lives, even lay down their lives, for the cause of establishing the deen of Allah. They are the party of Allah. Ulaika Hizbullah. They are the party of Allah. And there are those who oppose it, tooth and nail. Even they sacrifice their lives to protect their interests. But they are the party of Shaitan. Ulaika Hizbul Shaitan. Now this has to be identified. This struggle, this conflict. If we have a concept of madhab, there is no conflict whatsoever. You go to your church, I am going to my mosque. That's all. He is going to the temple, he is going to the synagogue. Nothing. No argument. But regarding the system, a few people here are resenting. These multinationals, what is happening? What happened in Seattle? But these things are to happen. So, when there is the question of system, it's a different matter. When only it's a system of belief and a system of some modes of worship and some rites and rituals and some feasts, okay, you can have yours, I can have mine. But this conflict, if you want to establish the deen of Allah, then there is going to be a conflict. No escape. So this surah mainly, but you know that Hizb al-Shaytan consists of two types of people. One are who are openly opposed, the disbelievers, the rejecters of the faith. And there is the other element, the hypocrites, who are legally with the Muslims, with the Hizbullah, but they are the fifth columnist. Fifth column. They look to the interest of the kuffar, working against the interest of Hizbullah. So this is very important surah regarding this. One thing must be clear here. This establishment of the deen of Allah is not possible without a party. Individuals cannot do it. It's very simple, very logical. An individual can go on calling and calling and calling and calling. But he cannot establish the system of Allah without having a party. If he doesn't get a party, okay, he won't be able to establish. If there was no party available to Nuh alayhi salam, no harm to Nuh. The people were drowned. Muhammad got sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a party. People who were ready to sacrifice their lives, to spend everything they had. So then there was a struggle, there was a conflict. which reached the level of armed conflict. The polarization became complete. Hezbollah versus Hezbollah Shaitan. And then, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the help. And the deen of Allah was established. But party is essential. So first of all, please note that if you have the concept of Islam as that of a deen, you must think that to strive to establish the deen of Allah is farz. Farz-e-ain. It's a duty. It's obligatory. Not something additional. Not something optional. No. It's not like tahajjud. No. Farz. Like the five prayers. Like the fasting of the month of Ramadan. Number one. And number two, this is a farz which cannot be fulfilled without a party. Just as you cannot pray without wuzu. Wuzu is not required in itself. Wuzu is the precondition, prerequisite for salah. Really what you want to do is salah, prayer. But for that is the precondition of wuzu. In the same way, the farz is to establish the deen of Allah, to strive your hardest to establish the deen of Allah on earth. But the prerequisite that you should be a part of a party, belong to a party. If there's no party, you stand up, call people towards you. They will join hands with you and it will be a party. If you are two, you have to pray in a jama'ah. One is amaat, the other is muqtadi. If there are two, you are a party. One is amir, the other is ma'mur. But not without a party. But when this party swells in numbers, and you know their commitment and depth of commitment reaches that level, and you know their determination to sacrifice everything reaches that level, required level, then there is a direct confrontation between haq and batil, between the truth and the falsehood, between the Hezbollah on one side and the Hezbollah Shaitan on the other. So this distinction between Hezbollah and Hezbollah Shaitan is the main axis of this Surah Mujadalah. But in the first four ayat, as I told, there is a special family laws issue. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قد سمع الله قول التي تجادلك في زوجها وتشتكي الى الله. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heard the words of that woman who pleads with you, O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, concerning her husband and makes her plea to Allah. An incident took place. Aus ibn Thabit Ansari radiallahu anhu, he did zihar with his wife, Khawla bint Sa'labah. Zihar in the old Arab tradition was that if a husband said to his wife, you are to me like a mother, or like the back of my mother. Now they are separated, divorced, and there can be no, you know, union again, or whatsoever, no way. Complete, permanent separation. Now in a fit of anger, Aus ibn Thabit said this to his wife, Khawla bint Sa'labah. They had children. Now Khawla came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She was weeping, crying. What shall I do? What has this my husband done? Where will these children go? How shall I support them? Weeping, crying. Oh, Muhammad, find some way for me. And the Prophet said, I don't find any way. No revelation has come to me up till now. But then the revelation comes. And Allah said, لَقَدْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ قَالَ الَّتِي تُجَادِلُكَ فِي زَوْجِهَا. Oh, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, verily, indeed, Allah has heard the words of that woman who was pleading with you, O Prophet, concerning her husband, and make, also she was making pleas to Allah. Oh, Allah, send me. Come, open some door for me, O Allah. Where can I go? So Allah said, we have heard. وَاللَّهُ يَسْمَعُ تَحَابُرَكُمَا. And Allah was hearing the conversation between you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ بَصِيرٌ. Verily Allah is all seer and hearer. Now comes the solution. الَّذِينَ يُظَاهِرُونَ مِنْكُمْ مِنْ نِسَائِهِمْ. Those of you who say concerning their wives, be as my mother's back. مَا هُنَّ أُمَّهَاتِهِمْ إِنْ أُمَّهَاتُهُمْ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَلَدَّهُمْ They are not their mothers. Their mothers are only those who gave birth to them. وَإِنَّهُمْ لَيَقُولُونَ مُنْكَرًا مِنَ الْقَوْلِ And surely they are saying a very loathsome word. وَزُورًا And a lie. إِنَّ اللَّهَ الْعَفُورَ غَفُورَ Verily Allah is pardoning, forgiving. وَالَّذِينَ يُظَاهِرُونَ مِنْ نِسَائِهِمْ ثُمَّ يَعُودُونَ لِمَا قَالُوا As for those who do this zihar to their wives, but then they want to take back. فَتَّحْرِيرُ رَقَبَةٍ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَتَمَعَصَّ So one slave has to be freed before the two of them touch one another. This is the fine. ذَلِكُمْ تُوَعَذُونَ بِهِ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ This is to what you are exhorted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows and He is aware of what you are doing. For مَنْ لَمْ يَجِدْ Whosoever cannot free a slave, he doesn't have that much money with him to buy a slave and then free, set him free. فَسْيَامُ شَهْرَيْنِ مُتَتَابِعَيْنِ مِنْ قَبْلِ يَتَمَعَصَّ So now he has to keep fast for 2 months, consecutive months, before the two of them touch one another. فَمَنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطَعْ And if somebody is sick, ill, diabetic, for example, and he can't do it, فَمَنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطَعْ فَإِطْعَامُ سِتِّينَ مِسْكِينًا Then he should feed 60 indigent persons. ذَلِكَ لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ And this is so that you should know and be convinced that you have the real faith in Allah and His Messenger. وَتِلْكَ حُدُودُ اللَّهِ And these are the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِلْكَافِرِينَ عَذَابٌ عَلِيمٌ And for the disbelievers, there is a very painful chastisement. Now these are the 4 ayats which have a different issue altogether. But now the issue connected with Surah Al-Hadid. Because these 2 surahs are a pair. Now that conflict between haq and batil, deen haq and those who oppose it. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحَادُّونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ Verily those who oppose Allah and His Messenger. يُحَادُّون is from حَدِيد. The same root. حَدْ, حَدِيد. يُحَادُّون, يُحَادِدُون. بَابِ مُفَعَلَ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحَادُّونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ Those who oppose truth and name. Allah and His Messenger, قُبِتُوا كَمَا قُبِتَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ They will be humiliated as were those humiliated who were before them. فَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ We have already sent down very clear revelations. وَلِلْكَافِرِينَ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ And for these believers, there is going to be a humiliating chastisement. يَوْمَ يَبْعَثُهُمُ اللَّهُ جَمِيعًا فَيُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا عَمِلُوا On the day when Allah will raise them all together and then He will tell them what they have been doing. أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ Allah had kept a record of their deeds. وَنَسُوا They had forgotten. وَاللَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ And verily Allah is a witness to everything. أَلَمْ تَرَىٰ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ Don't you know that Allah knows whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. مَا يَكُونُ مِنْ نَجْوَى ثَلَاثَةٍ Now this is the 5th columnist portion of the Muslim Ummah, the Munafiqun. They used to have secret meetings, secret consultations, planning against the Prophet, against the Muslims, going to the Jews and you know saying that we will be with you and so on and so forth. So this secret counseling, Allah knows everything which is in the heavens and the earth. مَا يَكُونُ مِنْ نَجْوَى ثَلَاثَةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ رَابِعُونَ There is nowhere a secret consultation between 3 of them. But the 4th is Allah. هُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَنَا مَعْكُنْتُ Wherever you are, He is with you. So you think we are 3? No, you are 4. Allah is there. وَلَا خَمْسَةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ صَادِسُهُمْ And if they are 5, then Allah is the 6th. وَلَا أَدْنَى مِنْ ذَلِكَ And no less than that. وَلَا أَكْسَرَ And not more than that, illa huwa ma'ahum aynama kanu. But he is with them wherever they are. Now we have this ayat in Suratul Hadid, huwa ma'akum aynama kuntum. Here only the pronoun has changed. Huwa ma'ahum aynama kanu. Summa yunabbihuhum bima amilu yawm al-qiyamah. Then on the day of judgment, on the day of resurrection, he will tell them what they have been doing. Inna Allah bi kulli shay'in alim. Verily, Allah knows everything. Alam tara ila allatheena nuhum 'anil najwa. Don't you consider those who were forbidden from these secret counselings? This comes in Surah An-Nisa also. But now these ayat, as I told you, they were revealed in the last period of the Madani days. ثُمَّ يَعُودُونَ لِمَانَهُ عَنْهُ. But they are doing what they were prohibited to do. وَيَتَنَاجَوْنَ بِالْإِسْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ وَمَعْصِيَةِ الرَّسُولِ. And they are having secret consultations among themselves for sinning and enmity and disobedience to the messenger. وَإِذَا جَاؤُوكَ حَيَّوْكَ بِمَا لَمْ يُحْيِكَ بِهِ اللَّهِ. And when they come to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they salute you with which Allah has not saluted you. The salutation in Islam is As-salamu alaykum. These munafiqoon, when they used to come, they should say, As-salamu alaykum, ya ayyuhan nabi. As-salam means death. Death to you, O Messenger. As-salamu alaykum. As-salamu alaykum. Omitting the lam in between. If somebody said, what have you said? Oh, I said As-salamu alaykum. What has happened to your ears? Go and get the wax out of your ears. I said, As-salamu alaykum. But this was their method. وَيَقُولُونَ فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ لَوْ لَا يُعَذِّبُنَ اللَّهُ بِمَا نَقُولَ. And then they say in their hearts, whatever we have said, why is not Allah chastising us? It means he is not the Prophet of Allah. Had he been the Prophet of Allah, we have insulted him. Allah should have chastised us immediately. But he is not doing it. It means he is not. It proves he is not the Messenger of Allah. حَسْبُهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ يَسْلَوْنَهَا وَبِيْسَ الْمَصِيرِ. For them, sufficient is the hell. And they will enter it, and it is a very bad and evil destination. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا تَنَاجَيْتُمْ فَلَا تَتَنَاجَوْا بِالْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ وَمَعْصِيَةِ الرَّسُولِ. O you who believe, if you have ever to consult secretly, your secret consultation should be not for sin or enmity or disobedience of the Rasul, but تَنَاجَوْا بِالْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى. Do this consultation for virtue and piety. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي إِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. And fear Allah, to whom you will be gathered anyhow. إِنَّمَا النَّجْوَى مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. This secret counseling, party within party, the Hezbollah, but they have a special group in that Hezbollah. So this is conspiring. إِنَّمَا النَّجْوَى مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. This Najwa is actually from Satan. لَيَحْزُنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. So those who believe, they should be hurt. وَلَيْسَ بِضَارِّهِمْ شَيْئًا. But he cannot do any harm to them. إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. But with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. And verily in Allah should all the believers put their whole trust. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا قِيلَ لَكُمْ تَفَسَّحُوا فِي الْمَجَالِسِ فَافْسَحُوا يَفْسَحِ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. O you who believe, when it is said to you, make room in the assemblies. Then do make room. What used to happen, you know, the Muslims have gathered, the prophets there, some consultation on some matters continuing. Now these munafiqeen used to sit in one corner, very close to each other, whispering to each other, so that others shouldn't listen. And you know, when it was said, okay, tafassahu fil majalis, open the place between you. Why are you so much grouped together? So, for the believers, it was the commandment. Whenever it is said, make room in the assemblies, do make it room. Allah will make room for you. يَفْتَحِ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. وَإِذَا قِيلَ انْشُزُوا فَانْشُزُوا. And when it is said, stand, you should stand. When it is said, the assembly is dismissed. The parade is dismissed. Now you go. But they used to keep sitting over there. and continuing their, you know, mutual consultations. فَانْشَدُوا يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ. Allah Ta'ala would exalt those of you who believe and those who have been given the knowledge. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. And verily Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala very well knows and is aware of what you are doing. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نَاجَيْتُمُ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ نَجْوَاكُمْ صَدَقَةً. Will you believe, when you have to have a secret meeting with the Messenger of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, these munafiqeen, because they were very wealthy people, to show off that we have a special position, they would say, Ya Rasulullah, I want to say something to you in secrecy. So please give me time. Now, the other congregation thinks that he is very close to the Prophet and Prophet listens to him. So now, to put a check, this order came. When we want to have a secret, a private meeting with the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَقَدَّمُوا بَيْنَا يَدَيْا نَجْوَاكُمْ صَدَقَةً. Give alms before your counseling. Give something to the poor before doing this. ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَأَطْهَرٌ. This is much better for you and more purer. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَجِدُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. But if you are very poor, you don't have anything, okay, Allah is forgiving and merciful. For the poor, there is no harm. But those rich munafiqs, if they want to have a secret meeting and hearing with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they should give something in the way of Allah first and then come. Now those people, they loved wealth like anything. Now they stopped. أَشْفَقْتُمْ أَن تُقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ نَجْوَاكُمْ صَدَقَةً. Have you become afraid of giving alms between your secret meeting with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? فَإِذْ لَمْ تَفَعْلُوا, when you didn't do it, فَتَابَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has relented on you. Okay. He is giving the concession. فَتَابَ عَلَيْكُمْ. فَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ. Now at least establish the salah properly. فَآتُوا زَكَاةَ. Do pay zakah definitely. وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. And obey Allah and His Messenger. وَاللَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. I verily, surely Allah is aware of what you are doing. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ تَوَلَّوْا قَوْمًا غَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. Have you not considered those who have become friends with those on whom there is wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Who are they? The Yahud. مَغْزُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ. مَغْزُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ Yahud. And these munafiqs, they had friendship with the Yahud. They are in some cases working agents to Yahud. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ تَوَلَّوْا قَوْمًا غَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. مَا هُمْ مِنْكُمْ وَلَا مِنْهُمْ. These munafiqs, these hypocrites are neither from you nor from them. They are sincere to neither you nor them. They are sincere to none. They are not sincere to Allah. They are not sincere to the Messenger of Allah. How can they be sincere to the Jews? But you know, they are after their own gains. وَيَحْدِفُونَ عَلَى الْكَذِبِ. And they take oaths on something which is not, which is not true, wrong, and lie. وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. And they do it knowingly. أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا. Allah has prepared for them a very severe chastisement. إِنَّهُمْ سَاءَ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Verily, it's very evil what they are doing. لَنْ تُغْنِي عَنْهُمْ أَمْوَالُهُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا. Neither their riches nor their children will be of any avail for them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. They are the devourers of the fire and they will remain in that forever. يَوْمَ يَبْعَثُهُمُ اللَّهُ جَمِيعًا. When Allah will raise them all, فَيَحْلِفُونَ لَهُ كَمَا يَحْلِفُونَ لَكُمْ. They will swear before Allah also as they swear before you. وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ عَلَىٰ شَيْءٍ. They will be thinking that they are upon something. They have some footing. أَلَا إِنَّهُمْ هُمُ الْكَاذِبُونَ. Behold, surely they are the liars. اِسْتَحْبَذَ عَلَيْهِمُ الشَّيْطَانِ. Satan has gained the control over them. فَأَنْسَاهُمْ ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ. And he has made them forgetful of Allah's remembrance. أُولَٰئِكَ حِزْبُ الشَّيْطَانِ. They are the party of Shaitan. This party of Shaitan consists of two parts. The kuffar, openly against Islam and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and their agents, hypocrites among the Muslims. legally included as Muslims. Ala inna hizb ash-shaytani hum al-khasirun. Behold, definitely the Satan's party, they will be the losers in the long run. Inna ladina yuhadduna Allah wa rasulahu ulaika fil adallin. Verily those who oppose and fight Allah and His Messenger, they will be among the most humiliated ones. كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَأَغْلِبَنَّ أَنَا وَرُسُلِي. Allah has decided and prescribed and written it down. Certainly I and my messengers will be victorious. This is the divine law about messengers, not about prophets. Prophets were killed also, but no messenger of Allah could be killed. We have read this in Surah Safat. وَلَقَدْ سَبَقَتْ كَلِمَتُنَا لِعْبَادِنَا الْمُرْسَلِينَ إِنَّهُمْ لَهُمُ الْمَنْصُورُونَ وَإِنَّ جُنَّنَا لَهُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ. This decision of ours has already passed, that those of our servants whom we appoint as our messenger, definitely they will be helped, and definitely our army will be victorious. So the same thing comes over here. As I told you, important subjects are discussed in Quran at least at two places. So Surah Saffat, and here it is. كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَأَغْلِبَنَّ أَنَا وَرُسُلِي إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is powerful and mighty, and He has all the authority in His hands. لَا تَجِدُ قَوْمًا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. You will not find those people who really believe in Allah and the last day. يُعَادُّونَ مَنْ حَادَّ اللَّهِ. Loving those who oppose Allah wa Rasulahu and His Messenger. وَلَوْ كَانُوا أَبَاهُمْ. Although they might be their fathers. أَوْ أَبْنَاهُمْ. Or their sons. أَوْ إِخْوَانُهُمْ. Or their brothers. أَوْ أَشِيرَتُهُمْ. Or their kindred. أُولَٰئِكَ كَتَبَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْإِيمَانِ. They are the people in whose hearts Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has inscribed and engraved iman. وَيَّدَهُمْ بِرُوحٍ مِّنْهُ. And has helped them with a spirit from him. That is Jibreel, the Ruhil Qudus. وَيُدْخِلُهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ. And he will make them enter and admit them in the gardens underneath which the rivers will be flowing. رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ. Allah will be pleased with them. وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ. And they will be pleased with him. أُولَٰئِكَ حِزْبُ اللَّهِ. They are the party of Allah. Now this is the polarization. On the basis of Allah and His Messenger. People who have belief in Allah and Messenger to this side. Those who don't believe on the other side. Even if he is your father, he is the enemy of Allah. You can't love him, you can't have any relation with him. Even if he is your brother. وَلَوْ كَانَ أَبَاهُمْ أَبَاهُمْ وَأَبْنَاهُمْ أَوْ إِخْوَانَهُمْ أَوْ أَشِيرَتُهُمْ. Whosoever he might be. This polarization has to be complete so that Hizbullah, it becomes absolutely pure and free. أُولَٰئِكَ حِزْبُ اللَّهِ. Now this word Hizbullah appears in this surah and also in Surah Al-Ma'idah. فَإِنَّ حِزْبَ اللَّهِ هُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ. In Surah Al-Ma'idah, غَالِبُونَ. The party of Allah will be dominant, will be victorious, will be supreme. And here, أُولَٰئِكَ حِزْبُ اللَّهِ أَلَا إِنَّ حِزْبَ اللَّهِ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Verily, the Hizbullah, they are going to be the prosperers and successors. فَلَاهِ is for the hereafter. And غَلَبَة, domination is in this world. So there are two promises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Hizbullah. Number one, in this world, they will be helped and Allah will give them the victory. فَإِنَّ حِزْبَ اللَّهِ هُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ. This is in Surah Ma'idah. On the Rad, Hizbullah, أَلَا إِنَّ حِزْبَ اللَّهِ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Verily, the people who belong to the Hizb of Allah, only they are going to succeed. Now let me, because I have 2 minutes, let me give you the hadith. The importance of this jama'ah. There's a hadith. إِنِّي أَعْمُرُكُمْ بِخَمْسٍ. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, verily, O Muslims, I command you five things. Allahu amarani bihinna. And I'm not doing it on my own. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded me to do so. What are those five things? Bil jama'ati. Party. You must belong to a party. Was sam'i. And to listen to the leader of the party. Was ta'ati. And obeying the decisions of the party. Wal hijra. And making hijra in the way of Allah. Wal jihad fi sabilillah. And then you can make jihad fi sabilillah. Jihad fi sabilillah essentially. As we read yesterday in Surah Al-Hujurat, if there's no jihad, there's no iman. It's the necessary constituent of iman. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا وَجَاهَدُوا بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الصَّادِقُونَ. Verily the true Muslims are only those who believe in Allah and His Messenger, then doubt not, and then they do jihad in the way of Allah with their belongings and their lives. This jihad, for that you need a party. This party should be a very disciplined party. Some of us, listen a little bit. وَعَلِ الْحَارِسِ الْأَشْعَرِيَّ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَىٰ عَنْهُ قَالَ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ إِنِّي آمُرُكُمْ بِخَمْسٍ اللَّهُ أَمَرَنِي بِهِنَّ بِالْجَمَاعَةِ وَالسَّمْعِ وَالطَّاعَةِ وَالْهِجْرَةِ وَالْجِهَادِ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. This hadith has been included by Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal in his Musnad. Also Imam Tirmidhi in his Jami'. And this thing has gone out of our sight and out of our mind. We don't feel something lacking. Are you involved in this struggle of Iqamatuddin or not? If yes, with what group? Which party? If you don't like any party, existing party, go on. You can form a party of your own. All the parties today which are present, they are also, none of them is led by a Nabi. There's no Nabi. No Nabi after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So you can have the, you are also not a Nabi. Okay, go ahead. And you can have a party. But without party, la islama illa bil jama'ah. This is the saying of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala. And the saying of a companion of the Messenger is also called Hadith. This is Hadith. And no less a companion than Umar radiallahu ta'ala. The second topmost sahabi. La islama illa bil jama'ah. Wa la jama'ah illa bil imara. Wa la imara illa bil sama'ah. Wa la sama'ah illa bil ta'ah. There's no Islam without jama'ah. No jama'ah without amir, imara. No use of having an Amir without listening to him. And no use of listening to him if you are not obeying him. May Allah give us the right guidance and give us the correct understanding of our duties as Muslims. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafa'ni wa iyyakum bil ayati wa zikri al-hakim.